We're going to look forward now to the FA Cup qualifying action this coming weekend. Two Ulster Senior League sides on the road, Bunnagee United and the USL champions, Coghill Celtic. Coghill manager Gavin Cullen joins us to look ahead to the game. Gavin, good to see you again. Welcome on to Highland.
Hi, Oisin. Thanks.
So, big game ahead. But before we look at your opposition, what's it been like for you over the last couple of weeks? Because we're going into a game that normally would be part of a season, but in your case it's not, Gavin. So how have you dealt with this out of season tie and preparing for what is a huge game for the club?
It is, yeah. Look, obviously it's very early in the season for us in terms of preparation, and where we're at is probably coming a bit early, but at the same time it's been a great game to focus our minds on preparing for, and we've got the players buying into it. No, they've been excellent the last few weeks. You can really see it ramping up towards the game in terms of training and in friendlies. So, look, we're looking forward to it. We're putting ourselves under no pressure going down there this week, because of the timing of it and because it's exactly 12 months since we've played a competitive game. So, look, we've nothing to lose. We're not going to win the FA Senior Cup, that's for sure. So, like, anything we get out of this game will be a bonus at the weekend, you know.
Yeah. But it would be nice to win on the road, so it would. And you've done that before against St Mochta's in this competition, haven't you?
We have, yeah. We beat St Mochta's in the FA Cup before. This is the third time we've played them. We played them twice in intermediate. They beat us twice in that, and we beat them the last time we've played. So, look, there'll be nothing between the teams. They're a very, very good side. They're current FA intermediate champions. Currently the favourites to win the Leinster Senior League, apparently. So they're going to be strong, like, you know.
Yeah. In relation to your squad, I know, Gavin, talking to you ahead of this game, a lot of change there. You've brought back a couple of household names for Coghill Celtic football, but you've brought in, there's been a huge influx of players under your squad for the new season, because you know, you did win the title last year. You did feel that you were a bit light. Are you a much stronger unit now, are you, Gavin?
I believe so. Look, time will tell. There's no doubt on paper. It's early days saying that, but it's probably in terms of strength and depth, probably the best squad we've ever had. It's very exciting. It's interesting. There's a lot of energy, a lot of young legs, and training and stuff. We've brought in 10 players and held on to everybody from our squad from last season. So we've been delighted how that went, and we knew we had the add, but what we've added is real quality and real competition for places. It's going into this weekend. It's the toughest I've had it to actually select a squad of 18 or 20 to play in the squad. Never mind pick the team. Picking the team is probably easier than picking the squad, and that's sort of the depth that we have at the minute. Time will tell if we can bring that onto the pitch, what we've been doing in training. But look, I'm excited and can't wait to see this group in action over the next season. You know.
So the likes of Peter Doherty's back, Garvin Freeland's back. Give us an outline of maybe who the 10 players are, Gavin, and who you've added.
Right, so, well, obviously Peter Doherty's back in Institute and Garvin Freeland's back in Australia, two huge players for any squad at any level. I've signed two goalkeepers, Daniel Houghton and Jamie Bell, both 21 years of age, a lot to prove, a lot of ability. In my opinion, both of them are more than capable of playing in the League of Ireland. At some stage, and I hope they use us maybe as a stepping stone or a pathway to fulfill their potential. I've signed Finn McClure from Carndonagh. He was with Derry. He was with Glengad last season. He's been excellent pre-season. He looks like a real player. We've brought on Corey McBride and Jack Doherty from Finn Harps. Again, very exciting players, young, energetic, lots of ability, lots of technical ability. Which again is, you know, we're really looking forward to seeing how they fit in and get in and fight for their places, because they're up against some very good players. Like Peter's up against Oisin McColgan, Jason Bresson, Johnny Havlin, and OBD for centre half position. So he's not even guaranteed to play, which is good, and it'll be good for him as well. We've six or seven forwards in the squad. Like Lawrence Tolan, Stephen Duffy, Mark Moran, all still there. Christy Faldara, Adam Duffy, and adding Garvin Field to that mix is really, really strength and depth, real quality. So Look, it's up to the players, and I keep telling them it's not up to me who plays. It's up to the players who plays, you know, and that'll be interesting going forward. We've added Dara O'Connor and Keelan McColgan, but at the minute they've Gaelic commitments, so they won't be available for the weekend. But we'll have enough like with the boys, and I can't wait to see them boys trying to get in the squad and team as well when they're available.
I think, Gavin, by the sound of things, you could be lining out two teams this season under the Cockhill Celtic banner, the way things are panning out, which is good for the club.
It is good for the club. We have a strong youth team that play in the National Premier Division, and the idea of that is having them strong, competitive at the top end of that league, and supplementing our squad and our squad players as well. So that's the plan. We train together as well, and in the last couple of years they've been doing very well in any showing, and that's expected to continue or improve. So again, for our squad players and for their better players to be pushing into the next our squad, we've benefited over the last year or so. We've had Keegan Higgerty, OBD, Adam Wanish, Shanti, Michael Noon, all youth team players coming into the first team squad and doing well. So Bradley Callan as well. So look, it's working, and that's the intention of the depth of the squad, you know.
Yeah. And just ahead of the game on Saturday, any of those players carrying any knocks or injuries, Gavin?
Yeah, we've Johnny Havlin's probably out. Lawrence Tolan's training tomorrow night. Fitness test, he's probably 50-50, and Oisin McColgan's 50-50. So, look, three big players, but as I say, we have more than adequate replacements. But I'm hoping they're fit, I'm hoping they're available, and I'm hoping it adds to the selection headache if they are. But yeah, we'll know tomorrow evening.
Yeah, listen, I know we're going into an FAA Cup weekend, Gavin, and just thinking as you rhymed off all these names and all these fantastic players that are going to be playing in the season ahead for Cockhill Celtic. Obviously, the Ulster Senior League title is your number one target to win that yet again. But I have it in the back of my mind here that the FAI Intermediate Cup is a competition that I know that you wanted to do well in, and it's eluded you over the last number of years, Gavin. Yeah. Are you building towards that, are you?
No, not necessarily. Look, leagues, first and foremost, every season, like the best team wins the league consistently. We've been lucky enough to do that. The Intermediate Cup is brought up every year to us, and it is one of them things that it's probably brought up more by other people than it is with us within a group. But of course, we like to win it. Of course, we're good enough to win it. Whether we do win it or not, that's a cup competition. You can be knocked out at any stage. So it'll be absolute madness for me to plan a season around a cup competition. But look, when it comes around to that, and whoever we get in the first round, we'll be focused on that and every round after that. And look, I've no doubt in my mind we're good enough to win the competition. I don't think there'll be a stronger squad in the country than us. But again, it's a one-off. It's a way draws. It's refereeing decisions. You just don't know. So, like, of course, we're going to aim to do well in the competition. But first and foremost is the league, you know.
Yeah. Finally, then, are you good enough to win on Saturday against St. Mochtus on the road?
Yeah, we are. Yeah. There's no doubt. I think ideally it would have been another 6 weeks down the line or whatever, and we would have had a lot more competitive games played, and we would have been more ready. They've had their first league game last week, and they've had a good pre-season, more than us, so they're probably that way physically ahead of us. But look, 11, it's 11v11, and I'm not too sure if their 11 is better than our 11, so on the day, a couple of decisions, a bit of luck. Like, there's no reason why we can't go and win the game, you know.
Yeah. Okay. Listen, Gavin, the best of luck with Saturday against St. Mochtus. Thanks for talking to us.
Cheers. Thanks, Austin. Thank you.